Thanks, Kingston.
I don't really need this when I'm speaking, do I? So my name's Tom. Hi. I came down from Huddersfield today. I'm on a 3-week tour of the UK at the moment. So the National Express is my best friend at the moment, which is a pretty sorry state of affairs, really. But thank you for having me. Good night. Cheers. The next song I'm going to sing is a song called Colour. And I wrote it about somebody who I care about very much, but I don't really see anymore. And she has a condition called synesthesia, which is where you see colours and shapes when you speak or see things or taste and bits like that. And I thought that's a beautiful thing, and it didn't work out. But it was this thing where we didn't really ever fall in love. You know when you get that buzzing here, and that never happened. And every time I left to go away touring, I kind of knew that it was ending, which kind of was sad.
Every time I leave, sinking stomach holding down the taste of fear. You're seeing colours, shades of which I've never seen. The crimson reds, the burning blues, the forest greens. We are everything we own, we're just wanted, we just can't connect the dots. Feels like a weightless shoulder song, you're burning bright. I lost direction. My love was years ago, fragile panic, and it's set in stone. And yeah, I meant it, took me years to brush it off, the endless black and chrome of love. I hate this feeling, it happens every time I leave. We every time I leave, hate this feeling. I hate this feeling. It happens every time I leave, every time I leave.
Haunting every time you think of me.
bed is burning just like the fires it used to see. A fading flame, a weak heart man, I'll always be.
Thanks.
Thank you. So you guys excited for Bob and Koji? Good. So you should be. I feel like I'm a teacher. I'm not. So this is my first time playing in church, which is awesome. I've played some pretty weird places before, but this is a lovely place to play. Not weird in the slightest. I like it. There's a man lying down there. I've just seen that. The next song is a song from my record, which I have for sale. I quit my job last year. I quit my job in January, and I decided to go touring full time because, as some of you are probably fully aware, it's the greatest thing you can do. Well, one of the greatest things you can do, in my opinion. I wasn't touring at this point in my life, but I was 19 years old, and I was over in Canada. I was touring with friends. And my sister called me one day to tell me her best friend had sadly passed away that morning. And she was only 18 and I was 19. So for the years before this had happened, I'd already, you know, I'd been there for my sister my entire life and I wasn't. So I had this kind of crushing weight on my shoulders. And I did for years until I wrote a song for her. And it's called Hold It, It Leaves. And it goes like, desperately searching my soul to find out if heaven has no windows and no doors. From across the Atlantic, I promised I'd find my way home. I called you from deep in BC. Jenny, the hope that it leaves. From across the Atlantic, I promised I'd find my way home.
Live your life and leave it all, 'cause all we hope sooner. Live your life and leave it all, 'cause I'll be home sooner than you know. Live your life and leave it all, 'cause I'll be home sooner than you know. And live your life and leave.
I hope that song's cheered everybody up on Monday evening, a wet Monday evening in Kingston. I think that's infinitely better than a wet Monday evening in Huddersfield. And Huddersfield's nice, but the journey down was not that fun. I tell the best stories, don't I? So
this, I'm going to play a new song now. I guess for quite a few of you, most of these are pretty new. But like I said earlier, I quit my job in January last year. Last year I played 133 shows, and I was incredibly proud of that because, you know, I'd given up my job and I wanted to pursue it because I love playing music live and singing my songs and telling my sad stories. And on the 13th of December last year, I played my last show and I was buzzing. I'd had the best year of my life, put out a record. And my dad called me. I was in Basingstoke, and I don't know if you guys know Basingstoke, but it's like a roundabout with clouds above it. That's the only way I can describe it. And I just played, and my dad called me. And you know when your parents call you, and the first thing that they say is, "Don't worry." So you automatically go, "Oh, like, what is it?" He did that, and he proceeded to tell me that he had had a heart attack that morning at home. He was on his own, but he called my mom, who, she's a nurse, which is useful. But she came back home, and she took him to hospital. And now, because I grew up on the Isle of Wight, and the Isle of Wight is seemingly 20 years behind everyone else, they couldn't perform keyhole surgery on him. So it got even more serious. So they had to fly him in a helicopter to Portsmouth, which he loved. He tells everybody that comes around now, "Oh, I've been on a helicopter now." Uh-huh. But they saved his life. And the way that he told me that it was going to be okay reminded me of just certain things that me and my dad are very similar in the way we explain things. And he isn't a saint, he's made his mistakes. But you know, nobody's perfect, and I'm incredibly thankful that he's still here. So he calls himself the Dude. I mean, it's ludicrous parenting. So this song's called My Father's Eyes. After I tune the guitar, and I'm going to be recording this song pretty soon. Oh, I don't want anybody thinking that I'm fed up, because I'm not. I'm like the world's happiest guy. And playing music for me is one of those things that contributes towards it. It really is. I love it more than anything else. Apart from my dog, maybe. But he still can't even work out how to wee outside yet. He's still a puppy, so I don't love him entirely yet. The next song I'm singing is a song from my record. Again, I keep talking about it, but guys gotta eat, you know what I mean? This song's called Symptoms, which is the title track from the album. And it's a song about an old couple that I met last year. I met them just once, and I walked, it was my like girlfriend at the time, it was her grandparents' house, and I walked in and I saw this old lady, bless her, she was only like, I guess, she must have been late 70s maybe, and she has a severe case of Parkinson's disease, which is pretty crippling really, and the medication that she's taking kind of fixes the shakes in her hands and her body, but also, I mean, she can't really respond to anything. She sits there pretty much like you do and can't do much. So I saw this firsthand and it initially made me very sad, but it also reassured me quite a lot, because her husband does everything for her, like from getting her out of bed and making sure she has the medication on time, and little things like sitting there with her and holding her hand while she watches TV. And I just happened to be there when this happened, but sometimes if he's a bit cheeky or a bit out of line, she'll like muster up the strength to like whack him to tell him off. And it was a really like warm moment, and I just figured it must be very difficult, because if you've been in love with somebody for 50 years, but then, you know, it doesn't matter what they go through, they're still in love, and that's reassuring. Because I've been single for a long time, ladies and gentlemen. So this song's called Symptoms. I hope you like it. You've got love in your head.
symptoms instead. As long as I breathe, I will patiently wait on your breath. And you've got love in your head. I've got the symptoms instead. As long as I breathe, I will patiently wait on your breath. I'm not lost, you know, pulling teeth and we're at home. We need to, oh, and I'm not lost, you know, pulling teeth. Cause I'm not lost, you know, pulling teeth and breath holes.
Thank you very much. Thank you for being so quiet as well. I've played shows in London before where, unless you're playing Oasis or Kasabian, people are like, shut up. But not on this tour, thankfully. It's been amazing. Even though I feel like the National Express is like my bed. I want to do a couple more. Have I got time for a couple more? Is that okay? Great. This song is actually about a church. this is a beautiful church. And there's a church next to my house on the Isle of Wight called Trinity Church. And it's where we held my grandfather's funeral. And this song was called Ghosts on Trinity. And we did a video for it, it's going out soon, but my mum's mum and my dad's dad passed away within 2 days of each other. So it was super weird, super sad, obviously, because the songs I sing are sad, but my dad's dad, yeah, passed away, and then we were mourning for him, and my mum's mum, just very coincidental, but because grandparents, whether they like it or not, ladies and gents, are hilarious. I don't think they mean to be half the time, they're just brilliant people. Like, until I was about 19 years old, my nan would still give me 50p every time I go around. So I think I've got a bunch of 50p's in my top drawer somewhere, I can't throw around. But for a lot of people, myself included, losing a grandparent is it's the first instance of like a family death. And it's always tough, but I miss them a lot, and their funny ways. So what I'm gonna do, I think it would be kind of criminal if I wasn't to play a song unplugged. Am I okay to do that last? No, not after this song, if that's all right. So this song is called Ghost on Trinity, and it goes like this. The start of it sounds like Tenacious D, but it's not, but you can be the judge. Your soul left your body. 2 days, two funerals apart, sat side by side in the church where your soul left your body. We washed our hands of memory and sadness, and the months that try the best we can through our love.
you stood around a tree.
Doing solo shows, I couldn't play behind the microphone. I was terrified of it, and I still am to some extent. So for me, playing down here kind of takes me back to when I was, I don't know, younger, I guess, which is what happens when you think about the past, because you're always younger. This is my last song. It's called Barstools, and it's a song I wrote when I was living in Southampton, and I'm playing tomorrow in Southampton with Bob and Koji, which will be great. And I was in a nightclub, like you do, the terrible places. And I was madly in love with somebody. And a week before, we had parted ways. But I was being a gent. I walked her home, you know, because that's what I do. I was brought up right, and you're a gentleman in that kind of scenario. So she then proceeded to tell me, ladies and gentlemen, that she was now seeing my workmate, which was fun. And I did something that I didn't think I'd do. I didn't hit her, by the way. I just realized where that was going. Like, I put my foot through the fence of our house because I saw red for the first time, and I was scared of this. I was like, well, why have I done that? Like, that's not cool. What she was doing wasn't overly cool, but you know, you get over these things. But I went past her house recently, and there were two like slabs of wood somebody's fixed, and for me, I just walk past going, right, okay, well, that's never going to change, that's happened. So basically, this song's about not being an idiot when you're drunk. It's called Barstools. Thank you for having me. My name's Tom, I play songs under the alias of The Lion and the Wolf.
There's a bar stool with your name on. There's a bottle with your last in the glass. My heart's anchored to the table, but we're drunk and they want us out fast. It's late and they want us out fast. I am frozen, but I'm able to see wood from trees in the grass. And I was hoping that you tremble and pick up the pieces you left. We'll put back together the rest. Go tell your lovers we lost everyone. We weren't meant to be tethered. We're coming undone, and you got what you wanted from me.
a good liar, I get scared when I speak. I've got friends who spit fire, they know how to breathe as my lungs filled with smoke. My throat was all choked, and you got what you wanted from me. So go and go be the liar, be the liar I know you can be. 'Cause you got what you wanted, you got what you wanted, you got what you wanted, you wanted from me.
Thanks again. I'm gonna be touring right through the year. Way into next year, I've got stuff booked up all over the shop, and I'm super stoked about that. I'm super stoked to be playing music full time. I've got some records and some shirts and stuff, but more importantly, I just love to hang out and say hey. So thank you again, and enjoy the rest of your evening. Cheers. Thank you.